Welcome back, everyone. This is the fourth and final video for Chapter 3 in Minerals. Our previous video had left off defining what ferro and non-ferro magnesium silicate minerals were. Let's go into a little more detail. Light or non-ferro magnesium silicate minerals do not have iron and or magnesium in them. Instead, they have aluminum, potassium, calcium, and sodium, and that's why they are light in color. They are generally less dense than our ferromagnesium. The most common non-ferromagnesium silicate mineral in the Earth's crust are the feldspars. So let's take a look at this feldspar group. It forms under a variety of temperatures and pressure. It has two directions of cleavage at 90 degrees to each other. And there are two common members. The potassium feldspars, in which orthoclase is the most common potassium feldspar, and plagioclase feldspars, which are sodium and calcium rich feldspars rather than potassium rich. This is a crystal of potassium feldspar. The most common variety is called orthoclase. Here is potassium feldspar as well, orthoclase again, showing two directions of cleavage. Here is a cleavage face and the top surface. That's your 90 degree angle. This is a fractured surface. It is not a cleavage surface. Below, we have our plagioclase feldspar, and this is a sodium-rich end member called albite. One of the features that plagioclase feldspar may exhibit on certain cleavage surfaces are these lines called striations. And that is an indication that you have a plagioclase versus a potassium feldspar. This is a sodium-rich member. This, on the other hand, has sodium and calcium in it. Here is a view of potassium feldspar shown in pink versus plagioclase feldspar. These are views under the microscope. Quartz is the second most abundant mineral in the Earth's crust, and it is composed entirely of oxygen and silicon. It is stable at the Earth's surface, so it does not weather and break down into any other mineral. There is no cleavage in quartz. It conchoidally fractures. When it does have crystal form, it is hexagonal. And it comes in a variety of colors due to impurities that may be introduced. Another non-ferromagnesium silicate is muscovite. This is a member of the mica family. It has one perfect direction of cleavage so that it peels off like pages in a book. Clay minerals are also classified as non-ferromagnesium, and clay makes up a large portion of our soil and is produced primarily from chemical weathering processes. Kaolinite is a common clay mineral used to manufacture fine china. Our dark or ferromagnesian silicates contain iron and or magnesium, which gives them their dark color. They have a higher specific gravity than our non-ferromagnesian silicate minerals. One common group is the olivine group, which is a high temperature silicate, and they are black to green in color and common in ocean crust and through, making up 50% of the Earth's mantle. Another common group of ferromagnesian silicates are the pyroxene group. They are found in igneous rocks, and the most common variety is augite. It is black to green in color, two distinct cleavages at nearly 90 degrees, And pyroxene is found in basalt, an igneous rock that we'll talk about in our next chapter. Another common dark silicate are amphiboles. Hornblende is the most common variety of amphibole. Black in color, very similar to augite, but you can distinguish between their cleavage directions. Augite has 90 degree cleavage directions in two directions, and amphibole has two directions as well, but not at 90 degrees, at 120 and 60 degrees. Here's a picture of augite, the pyroxene, and hornblende, and amphibole. Biotite mica is another dark silicate. It has excellent cleavage in one direction. And garnet is a simple ferromagnesium mineral. It is composed of individual silicon oxygen tetrahedron with iron and or magnesium attached. It lacks cleavage, it fractures instead, and comes in a variety of colors. Well-developed crystals have 12 diamond-shaped faces. This image here is showing olivine. The green mineral is olivine. And this is a beautiful example of a garnet showing its 12 faces. Let's move on to important non-silicate minerals. And they are divided into their groups based on the negatively charged ion or complex ion. They make up approximately 8% of the Earth's crust and oftentimes are economically valuable. Carbonates, halides, oxides, sulfides, sulfates, and native elements are examples of non-silicate mineral groups. This table is listing common non-silicate mineral groups, starting with the carbonates, an example of the mineral names, the chemical formulas, the economic use, and then a visual of the mineral. So this is nice to take a look at to give yourself an idea of some of the most common non-silicates. Carbonates are quite common as a non-silicate mineral. The two most common are calcite, which is calcium carbonate, and dolomite, which is calcium magnesium carbonate. You can see that the CO3 2- anion is what classifies it as a carbonate. It makes up limestone and dolostone, and that is used for road aggregate, building stone. It's used for Portland cement as well. Additional non-silicate minerals that have economic value include salt or halite. Gypsum is made, is used to make plaster and other building materials. Hematite and magnetite are mined for iron ore, which we use to make steel. Sulfides, sulfur is extracted, and sulfuric acid for industry is made from sulfide minerals. And then our native elements, gold, silver, and diamonds, have their value as well. This is a picture of a salt mine, and you can see these large pillars. So they go in and they dynamite out all the walls, leaving these columns to hold up the overburden so that it doesn't collapse down. And then they extract the salt and bring it to the surface, clean it, and use it for various purposes, like in water softeners, to salt our food, to de-ice our roads, to preserve our food. This concludes our video series on Chapter 3 on minerals. Our next series of videos will be on igneous rocks and volcanoes.